Well, children, in this class we are going discussing about extraction of metals. Extraction of metals will be learned under the chapter called as General Principles and Isolation of Elements. The term General Principles itself says that we are going to learn a basics of extraction methods of the metals. Under this, we need to know certain points, certain terms under the metallurgy. What are those simple terms or basic terms? No, first of all, how these metals are going to occur? These metals are going to occur in the earth crust, either in the form of combined state or in the form of a free state or native state. Which of the metals are going to occur in the combined state and which kind of the metals are going to occur in free state or the native state? If I say the metals which are going to occur in the free state and the combined state, here I would like to differentiate all the metals in different three different categories. What are those three different categories which we come across? The metals which tend to be more reactive and moderately reactive. That is one category. And secondary category is less reactive. And the last category is least reactive. Thus, based on the reactivity of these metals, with respect to the non-metals such as oxygen, sulfur, halogen, they are broadly, you know, mentioned in three different, they occur in mainly two or three, it is in the combined state. Number two, it is a free state. This free state is nothing but native state. And the other one is partly free state. So therefore, the occurrence of the metals are broadly classified into three different ways. One is combined state. Those metals which are more reactive are moderately reactive metals are going to occur in the combined state. Those metals which are least reactive, the metals which are least reactive, which occur in the free state, and the metals which are less reactive, they are going to occur in partly free states. Let us see which of them are said to be more reactive and moderately reactive, which of them are said to be less reactive, which of them are said to be least reactive. And you all know that the metal activity series, wherein the metals from sodium or of course potassium to whatever the element which comes above hydrogen, I say it is lead. These metals occur in what combined state? Either as their oxides, or their sulfides, or their sulfates, or their halides. Now, those elements which are less reactive, which are those mainly copper, mercury, and of course partly silver, these metals are said to be less reactive and they are found to occur in their partly free state. And the last one, you have gold and platinum. They are being least reactive, therefore they occur in the free state or in the native state, mean to say that they are free from many of the impurities. Amount of the impurities associated with this force is very, very less when compared to that of your less reactive metals, and of course in the case of very reactive or more reactive metals. What is the different forms of the ores which we come across? The different forms of the ores which we come across are, it can be, in the previous classes you learnt about, I need to say in the 11th standard, group number 16 elements are said to be chalcogens. Why group number 16 elements are said to be chalcogens? The term charcogen can be derived from the term or the way they are said to be ore forming elements. Which of the elements are said to be ore forming elements? Ore forming elements are group 16 elements. Group 16 elements are said to be ore forming, or we say they are as chalcogens. The elements which we come across under group number 16, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. But when we come across with the ores, the metallic are the ores, they either in the form of their oxides or in the form of their sulfides or sulfates or sulfides or in the form of both sulfur and oxygen. That's why we say group number 16 as ore forming elements, or I say chalcogens. Thus, we come across with the ores of different forms based on which is that non-metal which is mainly associated with the metal along with some other less amount of the impurities. Therefore, we are going to now learn about different types of the ores. What are those different types of the ores which I am going to mention now based on the non-metallic element? First one, as they occur in the form of oxides, therefore we call that as a oxide ores. Some of the metals occur in the form of their oxide, and I am going to mention some of them as which are those oxide ores. Oxide ores as mainly you find moderately reactive metals such as iron occurs as Fe2O3, Fe3O4, right? And of course you have Al2O3.XH2O, as well as you have zinc oxide, as well as Al2O3 alone, as well as you have SNO. Okay, these are the different oxide ores. There are plenty in number, but right now I gave only few. And we have that as Fe2O3 as hematite, Fe3O4 as magnetite, this is bauxite, this is alumina, and of course one more, of course it is zincite, and it is SNO, the ore of tin. And also found for your copper, copper occurs in the form of, I say, cuprite, but they are not necessarily to be very chief ores of that particular metal. Just I mentioned here the oxide form of the ores. Next type as sulfide ores. Example for sulfide ores as we have mainly starting from FeS2, that is said to be your FeS2 iron pyrites, followed by CuFeS2 copper pyrites, followed by ZnS called as zinc blend, followed by PbS, followed PbS is called as galena, followed by you have mercuric sulfide called as cinnabar, and you have the silver Ag2S, that is said to be silver glands. So these are the few ores which occur in the form of their sulfide. There are plenty, but right now I restrict to this. Then followed by sulfate ores. What are those metals which are mainly found to occur in the sulfate ores? We have CaSO4 2H2O, we call that as a, any area, CaSO4 acts, what do you call that as, gypsum. And we have MgSO4 7H2O, it is called as Epsom salt, followed by you have BaSO4 called as barytes, and of course sodium sulfate also will be found as a Glauber salts. But these are the most important sulfate form of the metals. Next, followed by you have some of the metals occur in the form of carbonates. What are those different metals occur in the form of carbonates? First one is CaCO3, limestone, FeCO3, siderite, followed by you have ZnCO3, calamine and dolomite, etc. in the form of their carbonates. And the next type of the ores which I say as halide ores. So let us see what are the different halide ores which we come across. When I say halides, the more reactive metals are mainly occur in the form of their halide ores, as halide ores mainly I say sodium occur in the form of sodium chloride. It is also found to occur in sea, I mean to say called as a sea salt, as well as rock salt. And you have KCl, MgCl2, 6H2O, that is said to be your carnallite, and followed by you have AgCl as horn silver. These are the very, and the most important is Na3AlF6. Na3AlF6 is said to be cryolite, which is one of the important ore of aluminium, as well as CaF2 is called as a fluorspar. It is a ore of, once again, calcium. So these are the important ores, different oxides ores of different metals.